there a B? Alright. To Titan it is. Launch!
Lunch?
Launch! Launch? No, I said lunch! Launching it is!
You can just change the U and A.
We're gonna find, Zavala.
Dude, that was a fucking great office joke setup.
Sorry.
So mad at you right now. It's one of my favorite interactions between Angela and Kevin.
Oh, that's... I don't know every joke in The Office. I've only watched like the series like twice.
This has technically been my second rewatch because it took me a long time to finish it the first time around because I never saw the last season.
Oh man, the last season is... It's a season.
Well, I watched it recently. The only thing I didn't like about it was the thing with the crew member.
Right.
Everything else wasn't horrible. Like, I don't know. I didn't hate it.
Yeah.
I also like Catherine Tate, though. So there is that. And I feel like you kind of have to in order to enjoy that season. Like, you have to be super into her. Because I've heard that's most people's complaints about that season is her character.
Yeah. I really like Titan. It's, like, neat to watch and look at the way it moves and the water and all that.
Yeah. It's been so long since I played it.
Well, getting back in the habit.
It's like
we're getting Sister Act 2 back in the habit.
Oh my god. Fucking stepped on my line for a Sister Act joke and now I can't remember what I was gonna say. Thankfully, Destiny is one of the few games that has, like, a fucking, goddammit, universal, like, button system. X is jump.
Yep.
You aim shit the same way. To do a special thing, you hold down both triggers.
Ooh, that's close. Destiny's like riding a bicycle. You don't forget.
My ass, if you put my ass on a fucking bicycle right now, I would fall over. I haven't ridden a bike since I was like 14 years old. I am 28. The body forgets, okay?
That is true. Like, I was first taught to ride a bicycle when I was 4. And then, I had to relearn when I was like 11. Because if you'd let me... Because if you had let me finish, I was going to say Destiny is like riding a bicycle. You never forget, you just don't do it.
You stepped on my line for a Sister Act 2 joke.
Man, look at that view. Who wants to go swimming?
Jesus Christ. Like some Waterworld interstellar shit.
Kevin Costner comes out of here.
With Matthew McConaughey.
Oh, jeez. We gotta get together and do some cyberpunk.
Sure.
You don't know what that is?
No.
The
Dude, I have not paid attention to games in fucking
You mean the D&D manual I sent you like a month ago?
Oh, I thought you meant that was a video game. No, well, that I have saved on my laptop and I'm actually going to read it.
It's going to be a video game, but it was based off that. And
yeah.
I'm hyped about it and I want to play it. And I've been like making a character in my spare time at work. And I was like, Lee, you should make a character. And she was like, I will when I know we're going to get the fuck together and actually play.
Yeah, I have the same philosophy because I'm not going to plan out a character for weeks and months only to fucking sit on that shit for 9 months or some bullshit.
Maybe I want to write a campaign featuring characters.
Dude, I will tell you my shit when I know it's getting started. You should have a basic structure that you can do without other character information.
Says you.
I'm just saying.
Says you.
Yes, says me.
It's okay. Grenade launchers aren't that good anyway.
What?
It was a grenade launcher, and I was like, that's okay. Grenade launchers aren't that good anyway.
That you picked up?
Yeah.
Yeah, I picked one up too.
Woo!
Oh, the range on that is terrible.
Told ya.
Oh my god.
It's not great.
Dude, that was awful.
Yeah, it's not great. So every time I get a grenade launcher, I just dismantle it.
Oh my god.
It's like, what's the point?
Fucking waste of my time. I thought you were being sarcastic.
I don't know why,
but I thought you were being sarcastic.
I was not.
I'm like, nah, grenade launcher sounds dope. Why would that be a bad thing?
Hive breeding ground.
Sack destroyed. I'll show you a sack, motherfucker.
Oh, shit.
See, stuff like that is just way less effective because you know and I know that I have ovaries.
Oh, fuck. You know what? You dick.
I assume those sack-looking things are the sacks.
Yeah.
Get them away!
Destroy all them sacks.
That's what I do in my spare time.
I'm sure there are.
I don't
know
when I started laughing like Tommy Wiseau, but there you go.
Three's a crowd, Daddy.
God, I miss having good weapons. One thing I'll give Destiny 1, I had played it long enough that I had good weapons in it.
Well, we are just starting out.
I know, but this is pathetic. Like, having killing a Night Bee this hard is painful. I almost got him with that one fucking rocket. Yes! I got him, bitch!
Man, and here I was. I had my shotgun ready. I was ready to come and help you.
Thanks, man. I appreciate the support.
Well, you know it. You gotta give credit where credit is due. Oh, hey, Zavala. Been a while. Perhaps.
Sure, man.
Well, Well, you just gotta do your best, right?
Probably not.
Sure, no, you're guardians. Come on. Are you guarding? Then you're guardians.
Don't give me that in spirit bullshit. I have fucking superpowers right now, okay? You take that away, I am nothing.
You still have
guns? I am the guy dropping fucking fries at McDonald's.
You still have guns? We still have guns, though.
Yeah, I'm sure that that'll help when I fucking need to jump 50 feet vertically, unassisted.
That's bullshit.
What?
She's like, it's a straightforward op. All you gotta do is get in, flip a switch, and get out. And I was like, that's horseshit. It's never straightforward.
There's always a really angry guy in there. He always wants to kill us.
Hmm.
Oh, there's a guy. Now there's no guy.
Now there's no guy?
Now there's no guy.
There's plenty of guys. I don't need
but
to.
But I killed Nick.
I don't need to worry about every guy.
But I killed that guy. Something's not working.
Of course not, because it's never straightforward.
We got VVIT guys.
Have you tried turning it off and on again?
That's usually most of the battle right there. What the fuck? Don't go in there.
Alright.
Okay. There was a mine there. Oh, there's mines everywhere! Oh, yeah! And I'm dead anyway.
Well. Oh, jeez. Good job. Okay. Uh-oh. Hold on.
I panicked and I jumped.
Wait. Got that one.
Yeah, I didn't expect there to be more of them, and I jumped down and immediately activated two.
Jeez.
And then when I jumped, I went sideways and I fucking jumped off the map and died. So that was not fun. It wasn't good.
Not exactly. Oh, fuck. Not exactly your finest hour. It sounds like Dark Knight score.
Yeah, it does. Which, so excited for that to come out in IMAX again.
That was such a good time.
It was. I saw, dude, I like, this is the one thing I hate about Facebook. Well, I hate a lot of things about Facebook, but this is one of the many things I hate about Facebook was, in my honest staging, there was a thing about how I was going to go see the Dark Knight Marathon the next day, and I was, like, super excited.
I saw... Yeah, we all went together.
Yeah, because it was you, me, and Darren. And then, when we got out, we heard about the shooting.
Oh, man. God, that was rough.
Yeah, it was. That's still, like, I still get super paranoid in movie theaters. Whenever I see people walk in late, I'm always like, why are you here?
Yeah.
Fucking goddamn it. I was wiping my eyes, sorry. One bad thing about having a fan blow right in front of you is your fucking eyes get hella dry. But it's finally not boiling hot in my room, so that's
you know
cool.
When I think about it? When I think about it, like... The Dark Knight is an odd trilogy, like... The Dark Knight is the black sheep. Oh, fuck. Because, like...
What do you mean?
Because it's like, okay, Batman Begins, right? Oh, let me go to the Himalayas and train with Ra's al Ghul and the League of Shadows, and then, oh, here comes... Well, I mean, yeah, there's Scarecrow, but guess who his boss is? It's Ra's al Ghul. And Ra's al Ghul's here, and he's gonna destroy Gotham. And then you're like, oh, that's neat. And then Dark Knight comes along, and it's like, It's like, man, fuck the League of Shadows. Now I gotta worry about the Joker, and here's Harvey Dent and Two-Face, and oh man, this is fucked up. And then we get Dark Knight Rises, and it's like, oh shit, here comes Bane, and he's also, he broke my back, and he threw me into prison, and it turns out he's part of the League of Shadows, and oh, that's Talia al Ghul. So it's like, it's a series that's bookended by the League of by the League of Shadows, and then the middle part is just all Joker.
So well, yeah, because there was only three movies.
I know, but it's like the story was interrupted, you know?
Well, in yeah. Talia was fucking planning shit.
Well, you know.
And the League wasn't active.
You don't like? You didn't like Dark Knight Rises?
Not that much. There's so many fucking plot issues that I have with it that I keep picking up on every time I watch it. There's always something new that I'm like, what the fuck?
I haven't seen it in many, many years, so I don't remember.
I watched it like, man, it wasn't even that long ago. I think I watched like a few months ago. And there's like a few things that really bother me about it. And they bother me about it more and more every single time I watch it. Like, Alfred leaving. He would never leave Bruce, no matter what. The ending. He was one of the most famous men in the world. And he grew his hair out and then fucking went to a city where a lot of tourists from all over the world go. And he apparently lives there with Selena Kyle, and no one notices they're there.
No one's like, hey, is that Bruce Wayne?
Also, how does he get back into Gotham? He doesn't have money or any identification at all because he got dumped in a prison where he miraculously got his back fixed without any help at all of modern medicine. It was like a guy in a rope, which is bullshit. And it happened in like the matter of like it was a very short period of time. Let's see, there was also I've been so distracted by my anger that I have not been paying attention to what I'm supposed to be doing right now. There was more. The fact that this one is fucking never fails piss me off. It's he goes back to Gotham because Bane is about to blow up the city with a nuclear weapon. The city is closed off from the outside world. In all likelihood, everybody is going to die, and he's on an actual time limit with a clock and everything.
And he took the time to make the fire bat.
Yes! He fucking stops to make street art like he's fucking superhero Banksy.
He's like, let's Banksy this shit up.
It's fucking bullshit. Also, how did he know that Gordon was going to be there? Also, how did everybody in that movie suddenly figure out who the fuck Batman was?
He's not very good at hiding it.
At this point, there are more people that know than don't know. The Robin thing is still way too convenient for my taste. I looked at you and I just, you know, I knew that you were like me, like an orphan kid who somehow I became a cop and you became fucking Batman. That is still horseshit. I am not fond of that movie. There's more, but I've been so distracted that I don't know what I'm doing right now.
We're going up here. You were in the right place, but I fucked up my jump.
Oh, yeah, I came back down to revive you. So let's just get back up there, and then what?
Oh, there we go. Okay. There we go. It works!
Oh my god.
Oh my god. It's just never never enough for you.
Oh, fuck me.
I'm a fucking errand boy for you guys. Jeez. Why don't you do your own goddamn shit, Zavala? Oh, that's not gonna work. Oh, down I go. Down I go.
Oh, man.
Going for a swim.
I'm right there with you.
Going for a swim. Having myself a time.
I got it.
Well. You know what? Shut up, Sloan. Fuck. Think you're so goddamn smart?
Yeah!
Yeah! Fucking yeah!
Oh my god.
Okay.
I was supposed to say, if there's another fucking part of this mission, I'm gonna be real fucking mad. Like, oh my god. Titan's cool and all, but there's so much shit there that looks the fucking same, and I never know where I'm going.